There's a wet war going on here in New York. The weapons, acid spray and spray paint. The acid solution is sprayed on subway cars in this exotic urban car wash, 55 gallons per train in the costly battle against graffiti. Removing graffiti from the interiors and exteriors of New York's 6,000 subway cars costs the city more than $1 million a year. And razor-top barricades of steel have been erected around the train yards to keep out the enemy's spray cans. New York's mayor, Ed Koch, says the total cost of the war is $10 million a year.
I hate graffiti.
Sure, graffiti is ugly, messy, destructive. It's vandalism. Everybody hates graffiti, right? Not quite. The people who wield the spray cans don't hate it.
It's not vandalism. Anytime that you see form and color and space being used correctly, it's art.
Art? Art requires not only the artists, but beholders, believers, and buyers. And here they are, gathered at the opening of a graffiti art show at a fashionable gallery in New York's Soho district. Yes, suddenly, one man's vandalism is another man's masterpiece. Gallery owners and art dealers in New York and the capitals of Europe are cleaning up on what Mayor Koch is trying to clean up. No, art collectors are not buying up subway cars. They're buying canvases spray-painted like subway cars by willful vandals transformed by the whim of fashion into wealthy virtuosos.
They have an enormous future in the art world. They have what it takes. They're innovative. They've done something new. They've used new materials, new way of expressing art, and they've captured today's age.
At the age of 22, Richie Miranda Jr., who for years sprayed under the name of Scene, now sees his canvases sell for as much as $8,000 each. And Scene likes the praise he's heard.
It feels good. My head's all swollen.
Graffiti Chic has now expanded from the spray can to the tube. Graffiti Rock is airing in 94 TV markets. And Hollywood has produced a summer movie whose hero has a spray can he likes to aim at subways.
I'm a graffiti writer. I'm an artist. I don't just throw up little tags all over the place. I make them trains beautiful.
Beauty is in the eye of the beholder, and the role of the critic is to be critical.
I don't consider it an art form on canvas at all.
Most graffiti in New York, of course, is on subway trains, not on canvas. It's a form of social protest, more desecration than decoration.
I don't like it, and I don't think anybody does. Really, this is like my office. It's like if you went to your office and saw this scribbled all over your office, you wouldn't like it.
And so the war goes on. Stephen Geer, ABC News, New York.